So for example, if someone in California searches one keyword and someone in Minneapolis searches another keyword, but the end result is they still end up on the same listing, then we've pretty much built like the spider web of all these different keywords they can search, but they all end up on our listing.
Exactly. Let's jump in and see what those keyword phrases are that people are searching for. All you need to do here is What's up, guys? My name is Chris Hubby. I'm from San Antonio, so not too far south from here. I've been selling on Amazon for at least a couple years now, so I'm excited to meet you all. Last year, I was probably around $300,000 or so in revenue, typically close to about 30% profit margin. My best year was $100K or so in profit.
That's awesome.
Today I'm gonna share with you the keyword research that I used to pick my very first product. With that, you'll be able to kind of replicate exactly what I did and then determine the next steps in the process as well.
So here's my first question, Chris. Why is it important that I even do keyword research? Like, why does that even matter?
Well, you can't pick a product or launch something on Amazon blindly. You need to know what people are searching for on Amazon and fill a gap in the market. So by doing keyword research, we can see what people are actively searching for and tailor a product to what folks are already ready to purchase.
Chris, what is a keyword?
Simply, a keyword is whatever it is that you're typing in on the Amazon search bar. So you might hear it called a keyword or a keyword phrase, but if you're searching for dog food, a keyword for that might be dog food for a large dog. That's a long tail keyword. Someone might get lazy and just type in dog food, two words. That's also a keyword or keyword phrase.
How do I use keyword research to find a product that has huge potential to sell on Amazon?
Sure, so the first thing is to determine what people are searching for. What I like to use is a tool called Magnet by Helium 10. That allows us to see what people are searching for on Amazon, the specific things that they're typing in on the search bar. Once you've narrowed down keywords that you're interested in, you can take a look at the results that are coming up on Amazon and find areas where you may be able to launch a product that doesn't have enough relevant products already listed, or where you can differentiate from what's currently being sold.
By the way, stick to the end of this video. There is a tool we're gonna give you that allows you to build out a listing keyword strategy for your listing. We will share that link at the end of the video. What about search volume? Show me how to find search volume and what that is.
Sure, so we can use this tool right here to determine how much search volume there is for any specific keyword or product that you're interested in. So let's use wind chime as an example. If I type it here on Magnet and select get keywords, I can see exactly what people are searching for in relation to wind chime.
So this is gonna show me the volume, the search volume for this keyword on Amazon?
Exactly, we'll be able to see the search volume for any keywords that are related to wind chime according to this tool.
And by search volume, you mean how many searches shoppers are searching this keyword per month?
On a monthly basis, that's right. All right, so here are the initial results when we type in wind chime. There's over 8,000 keywords that are pulling up at the moment, and not all of them are gonna be relevant. So the filter I typically apply has to do with search volume. I'm gonna only look at keywords that have about 1,000 or more searches per month.
And are you doing that because you're looking for more high demand products?
Exactly, yeah, I don't care too much about specific keywords that only have a couple hundred monthly search volume because small market and it's gonna be hard to be competitive where a market is so small. So from here, I've got all of the wind chime keywords that are relevant that have over 1,000 search volume per month, and I can filter that and sort it by the top keywords that are popping up. In this case, we've got a bunch of other stuff that isn't necessarily relevant. The reason for that is this tool is bringing in anything that may be somewhat similar to wind chime.
But that's pretty broad.
Exactly. So what I would do to narrow this down even further is use this phrase contained section. What this does is narrow down the result set to specific words that we enter here to make sure that they're extremely relevant. So in this case, I will just type in wind and we'll only get results that have wind associated with them in the actual keyword phrase. So now we've got an extremely specific and relevant list of keywords. If you take a look here, the top one at the moment is wind chimes that has over 200,000 search volume per month.
So what you just did is it has to have the word wind in the phrase for it to pop up, which is why home decor is now gone.
Exactly.
Got it. So now we're super focused. What if I really want to narrow down even more?
Yeah, sure. So let's say as an example, you want to differentiate and not just have a specific wind chime. One of the things that I noticed have been trending lately are butterfly specific products. What we can do is if we want to see if there's any demand for something like that, we can simply type in butterfly here
So now it has to have wind and butterfly for it to pop up.
Exactly. So in this case, we've got two options, all or any. We're gonna leave it as all, which means we needed to include both the word wind and butterfly.
Got it. If I did any, it could be either or.
Exactly.
Got it.
So once we apply it here, we can see, yeah, there is some demand. There's about 9,000 searches or so for a specific butterfly wind chime.
How do you know when you've niched down so far it's too far and the demand is no longer high enough? Because here I'm seeing, yeah, your demand's going down a little bit because you're niching down. But like you said, you do want to niche down so you're meeting a specific avatar, a customer market.
Typically, I like to see at least a few thousand in search. A lot of the products I've launched are very niche. I'm fine going into market if there's a low search volume, if there's no relevant products for that market.
Which means your PPC costs are gonna be less because there's fewer sellers bidding on those keywords.
Exactly.
So less competition.
So we can take a look at one of them here. So let's jump into butterfly wind chimes. In this case, we've got 9,000 in search volume per month, and it looks pretty heavy at this moment as far as competitive products. When I launched a wind chime a while back, it was a sympathy wind chime. And when I clicked and was looking at the results for sympathy wind chimes, there was nothing specific to sympathy wind chimes.
Wow.
And that's why I decided to go in there, even though the search volume was only around 10 or 15,000.
Because you know if it's 10 or 15,000, even though that's not huge, you know there's people who want it. If no one's selling it, then you just found a gold mine.
Exactly, and that was the case. I was one of the first to market with a specific sympathy wind chime. So when people were looking for it, I was one of very few options when they were searching.
What about when it comes to seasonality? How do I know when a product is too seasonal to sell, and why would I want to be careful about that?
Yes, so we can take a look to see if there's any seasonality for butterfly wind chimes. One of the quick indicators is looking at search volume trend. Right here, this indicates that the search for that specific keyword phrase has increased 150% in the last 30 days.
Which is why it has the green arrow going up, I'm assuming, instead of a red arrow pointing down.
Exactly, so that is a pretty big jump. So in order for us to analyze that a little bit further, we can click right here on the graph symbol and take a look at the details for butterfly wind chimes.
What do you think of this? Because what I'm seeing is it has a real recent spike on around April 2022. Then you got a spike last November, right before December. Maybe that's Christmas sales, getting ready for it, maybe as a gift. But then it is pretty high if you go back to last summer. So how would you evaluate this climb and fall?
Yeah, definitely. I would expand the time that I was looking back to see if we see that pattern happen more frequently. Going back all the way to 2018 in this case, you can see that there are some pretty big peaks and valleys. And like you mentioned, right now it looks like it's at its height, which is May 7th in this case. Again, it reached some high volume in December for the holiday season, which is typical. Let's look at the highest sales volume time frame in 2021. And again, right around May.
So that was in May as well.
Yeah.
Something happens in May. Oh, summer's coming.
Summertime.
Spring is over. Let's hang these out there. That's fascinating. So that would indicate, since this graph looks like acupuncture, there's a strong chance this is a bit seasonal and we're gonna have to really have a strategy before we launch this. Because we might get great sales in May, but what about the rest of the year minus Christmas?
I agree. Yeah, for any beginning sellers, I would err on the caution of doing something seasonal because there are some specific nuances when it comes to inventory management and knowing how much to order for something that's ebb and flowing as much as this one is.
So you mentioned sympathy wind chimes.
Yeah.
Which you launched. So let's just assume I say, okay, I wanna do sympathy wind chimes. What's the next step I need to think about before I just go all in and launch this product?
Sure, yeah, so using the same tool here, I was scrolling through different wind chimes and the one that caught my eye was sympathy wind chime right here. So I pulled this up by clicking there, we're able to see all of the results that come up on Amazon. So these are all the specific wind chimes that are being sold at the moment. For sake of an example, let's just say we wanna take a look at the top Amazon choice for sympathy wind chimes. We can use another tool called Xray to see what type of sales volume it currently has on Amazon. So if I go here and select Xray, it'll give us all the details on the sales for this specific wind chime. In this case, it has over $54,000 in revenue.
On that one listing?
On that one listing.
Per month?
Per month. Let's say we did everything else and we validated that we wanted to get into the wind chime business, and this was the only other relevant sympathy wind chime currently active. If we thought there was a possibility for us to differentiate, then we could take a look further and to see specific keywords that this wind chime is showing up for on Amazon. The reason we wanna know what other keywords it's showing up for is because we want to have a list of all of the relevant keywords for this product. So when it's time for us to go and build a product listing, we plug in those keywords in different spots so that we're sending signals to Amazon on what exactly our product is and which customers should be seeing it.
So for example, if someone in California searches one keyword and someone in Minneapolis searches another keyword, but the end result is they still end up on the same listing, then we've pretty much built like the spider web of all these different keywords they can search, but they all end up on our listing to get the sale.
Exactly. Let's jump in and see what those keyword phrases are that people are searching for. All you need to do here is copy the ASIN, which is an identifier for the product that Amazon uses. And then we're going to jump over to a tool called Cerebro and plug in that ASIN. All right. So here's the result set for all the keywords that this specific product is ranking for on Amazon. As you can see, it's a pretty large amount, over 3,000 keywords, but we don't really care about the keywords that this product is ranking for on the fifth page of Amazon, because a customer is more than likely not going to go through that many results.
And that kind of customer is probably really picky. They're just looking through everything.
Exactly. And it might be a keyword that's not really even relevant in some cases. What I like to do is narrow it down to an organic rank of 1 through 30, which indicates it's likely on the first page for that specific keyword.
Because you typically get around 20 to 30 listings showing up on the first page of Amazon when you search a keyword.
Exactly.
So by 1 to 30, you mean approximately the first 30 ranking listings for that keyword.
That's right. Yeah. And the other match type I'll specifically indicate is organic. A lot of times you run pay-per-click advertising, and depending on who's doing it, they might be targeting keywords that aren't specifically relevant for their product if it's a new seller. So I only care about what's the ranking that's organic for that specific product.
And their organic ranking is like real ranking, because someone could artificially rank something using a sponsored listing or a PPC ad, but it's not real until people are actually buying it enough that it shows up organically. So you're really getting real results by filtering it to organic.
That's exactly right. So what we can do here now that I've got that is I like to filter by search volume to see what we've got. In this case, we can see that the wind chimes keyword has this specific product ranked as number 10.
In other words, the 10th listing that shows up when a customer searches that keyword, it's the 10th search result.
That's correct. But in this case, when we first launch a product, I like to be more specific and narrow it down to long-term keywords that are most relevant. In this case, we're launching a wind chime that's specific to sympathy, right? Wind chimes as a keyword phrase doesn't necessarily indicate that they're looking for our type of wind chime in this case. So what I'll do is I'll filter by organic rank. In this case, Amazon should be pushing a sympathy wind chime to the top of the page where it's most relevant. So if we take a look at the result sets here, we can see that there's gonna be additional keywords in here that might not necessarily be as specific and relevant as we hope for our wind chime, and we don't have to pay a whole lot of attention to those. But the keywords that are most relevant, we wanna pull those out and make sure that we include those in our list of keywords that we'll eventually use in our product listing and maybe for pay-per-click advertising down the road. So let's take a look at a couple of them. Memorial. I wouldn't include that one.
It's too broad.
Too broad, yeah. Religious wind chimes, not specifically, right? Ours isn't a religious wind chime, but wind chimes for memorial. That's a keyword phrase that's pretty specific and to me is almost synonymous with wind chime. Yeah, sympathy as
well. Totally, because they're thinking about their loved ones.
Yeah, so let's see what else we've got in here that makes sense. Sympathy wind chimes and memorial gifts for loss of grandmother. This isn't specific to a wind chime, but if you can see here, they're ranking number one for that. So people are searching for something more broad, but they are showing to convert for our specific product, even though they're not necessarily looking for a wind chime.
So based on what you just shared, Chris, are you saying this is good evidence that this is a potential product? Is there enough here to say, you know what? Now we know for sure there's multiple keywords ranking for this specific subcategory.
I would say that we have to take a couple of additional steps just to make sure. One of the main things is just overall search volume for keywords that are relevant, in our case, to a sympathy wind chime. So let's plug that in here. I want to see only results that have at least 1,000 monthly searches, and we can filter that and sort it by search volume. And let's take a look at the top search volume for those that we can definitively say are relevant. So we've got 17,000 searches in memorial gifts. We've got 12,000 specific to memorial wind chimes, another 12,000 for sympathy wind chimes. And if you keep looking down the list here, there's other keywords that don't have as much search volume, but they're still hyper relevant, such as memorial wind chimes for loss of mother.
Are there any last tips, Chris, that you would give to people watching this training on how to use keywords to find a potential product on Amazon?
I would say that keyword research needs to be performed when picking a product, but it's also extremely important to use those same keywords in your product descriptions and listings and in your pay-per-click advertising.
So a lot of the work that you're doing right now is actually serving the future. When you create your listing, when you run your PPC, when you optimize your listing based on those PPC results.
Yeah. We're just scratching the surface here. This is just extremely high level, but you want to have a list of relevant keywords for your product to help you along the entire process when it comes to getting something ready for Amazon.
JOD.com/listing. If you go there, there is a tool you can use to build out a listing that optimizes keywords, exactly what Chris has been sharing today. And it is such an honor to have Chris on the Just One Dime YouTube channel. He's bringing content for you based on his real life experience selling at Amazon. He has a wife, he has a 13-year-old child, a 1-year-old child. He's doing this for his family while he still works his regular job. Chris, what would you say to everyone watching? What would be your advice to them who are thinking about starting, but they haven't started yet?
I would say there's only so much content that you can consume. You've got to pull the trigger at some point and actually take the steps to get started with your Amazon FBA business. So use content like this to help guide you, but it's not going to do anything unless you actually execute. So that would be my advice to you, is to just get started and execute.
And if you would like to meet with someone to walk you through, okay, what do you need to get started? Try this. Go to jod.com/freedom. You can apply to schedule a meeting to meet with one of the Just One Dime staff members. They will look at your situation and see whether or not we can work with you to help bring your Amazon business to the next level. Hope you guys enjoyed the content today. Make sure you like and subscribe. And the question for you, if you could please type it below, is where are you at when it comes to keyword product research?
See you later, guys.